right, we are live again with another paint demo. I think this paint demo is going to be a caricature. I haven't painted a caricature in a while, but it would be fun to explore that. So that's what we're going to do. Guys, go ahead and give me some comments. Let me know you're here. Say hi, say what's up. Let me know how the sound is, all that good stuff. This is an extra exclusive paint demo. Says we got one viewer so far. So this is an extra exclusive paint demo. If you're not here now, you can definitely watch it in the future. We're going to leave it up. We got two. So if you're in here, go ahead and leave a comment. And let me know you're here. Today we're going to, like I said again, we're going to work on a caricature. I just found this really cool photo of this dude you can see right there, and I thought it was cool. I was like, man, it'd be a cool Frankenstein or something, so that's what I'm going to do. Got three viewers. Welcome, welcome, welcome. So this is exclusive just for the top tier patrons. Yeah, what's up, Brian? How you doing? Everybody, go ahead and comment if you're here. We only got a few people in right now, so. So, we only share this link with a couple of people, because we want it to be an incentive for those of you that are top tier patrons to continue to be that, and we want to make sure it's worth it. That was a bad place for that. So I'm just getting everything kind of situated right now.
I'm going to bring the comfy chair.
Bear with me for a moment while I get everything situated. All right, if you guys are in here, go ahead and comment. Looks like it's just you, Brian, for right now. But that's cool. You get a private lesson. I say private lessons, probably more like a private demo. You can take from it what you want. I'm playing around with a caricature today. Just getting my paint ready. If you were here for the last video, you saw how I do that. My trusty UVLS clear, the 4050 gloss clear.
Brian says $20 a month is cheap for what you offer.
Well, thank you, Brian. If you want to help out, try that super chat out. I don't know if that works or not. Or you can just share it with your friends. The more people we have here, the better.
No, that's only available in public videos.
Oh, well, you can't do that now. But if you can definitely share this video, and that would help out a lot. The more people we get in here, the better.
Not this video. This is for...
Oh, not the video. The Patreon page. Share the Patreon page. Let me put this up. I don't want to spill anything. I'm in my brand new, nice new tattoo studio, and I don't want to make a mess of it. Hopefully in the future, if this does better, we can set it up a little better. All right. Let's see, we got a rag over here. But yeah, Brian, it would definitely do us a huge solid if you told your friends about what we offer here. We're definitely working hard to, we're working very, very hard to create really nice content for everybody, make it worth it. I really appreciate the Patreon, and I really appreciate the monthly contributions, and so we're really working hard to make sure it's worth it for you guys to stay. We also have t-shirts. So I own, well, Faith and I both, we own a studio called Eden's Edge Tattoo, and we've got some merch on our YouTube channel for that. Those t-shirts, mainly, you know, you can wear them proud, but mainly it's just supporting supporting us here. There it goes. Now it's smoothing out. There we go. Okay. So I'm going to do a caricature of this fellow over here because I just thought he was neat looking. I'm going to start with kind of his... this kind of Gumby square head.
Brian said, I see you're in your 60s for patrons. That's really cool.
Yeah, it is. It's super cool. That's why we want to keep it up. That's super cool. That's not even close to what we thought when we started this.
You were the first patron.
Oh, was he? Well, thank you, Brian. So this is, you're basically, you get to watch me live kind of figure out a cool caricature of this dude, just because this dude was kind of cool looking. So hopefully all goes well. Feel free to ask questions. What I'm doing now is just trying to find the parameters of like where his eyes will be. Kind of find his shape, really. I haven't done a caricature in some years, so I'm just kind of warming up to it.
Brian said, you guys are awesome. I jumped on it right away when you guys offered it.
Well, thanks, Brian. All right. So I'm definitely trying to exaggerate the shapes right out of the gate, because I want to make sure, like, because what happens is when I start doing a caricature, I start making him like super realistic, or actually I get too close to his correct proportions. And so what I do is I try to make these exaggerated proportions in the beginning. That way they maintain their exaggerated look throughout the piece. So right now, just kind of sketching it out, figuring it out. Kind of like how he's flat-headed. I was going to make him kind of a pencil or like a eraser head, but I think I'm going to make it a little more flat, just so he's, maybe he'll be like a Frankenstein. So I'm using the exact same technique that we just went over. So everything's the same, the way that I mix it the same. He's just an interesting looking fella. The thing to remember if you're ever doing a caricature like this is their proportions, even though they're exaggerated, you still kind of got to stick to them to a certain degree. So, yeah. I can. Yeah, I can. I wouldn't call myself a master at it, but yeah, maybe after this I'll clean the airbrush for you. We'll just leave the camera rolling and I'll clean it out. It's definitely good to make sure that your vent hole on the top of the cup is always open. I try to work really light from, you know, side to side. That way everything, you know, everything kind of stays lined up. Every time I teach, my voice cracks. I think because I'm trying to project so loud, I'm like straining my voice. Or present or whatever. I guess I'm not really teaching right now. I'm just, letting you in on a little study. I feel like his eyes should be even closer together. Like, really want it to be kind of like, I really want it to be like exaggerated. Yeah, Brian, if you have any questions along the way, feel free. Otherwise, I'll just paint and kind of just talk a little bit. Is that speaker on? I'm gonna turn on some music. I have some free, like, unlicensed music I can play. Yeah, Faith, will you hit the power on that speaker? It's on. Basically, just some lo-fi, says copyright, royalty-free. Cool. Paint night. Has Florida been getting hotter or more humid? Nah, Florida's really nice. I just went jogging this morning. And I was, like, thinking about how nice it was while I was jogging. Like, I was just like, I was actually thinking that same thing. Like, it hasn't gotten bad at all. It's beautiful. In fact, like I said, we're under quarantine and we're not able to tattoo, which is a super ultra bummer. All the other people, they're able, you know, people with jobs right now, you know, that are able to work, they're having their weekend and they were out boating and things like that. And we had to put all that fun time to a halt till we can get the shop open. Although my friend Mike might take us out soon, but I was definitely getting jealous. This woman stopped me when I was jogging to ask me where the marina was. And I was like, I wish I was coming. Arizona's really hot. Yeah, Arizona's, it's definitely a different kind of hot. You guys got like that, like being in an oven kind of hot. We have just, dry heat. We have humidity to where it's just like, it's more sticky, more wet. You're more sweaty. But it's not as like physically hot. Here I'm doing a lot of that that technique we talked about, the jiggle or whatever we were calling it. Middle of the month, around the 16th, 15th, 16th, 17th, 18th. The lowrider, we're going to paint the lowrider around the 15th, in case you can't hear Faith. 15th, 16th, 17th, and 18th, I think. So I actually used to be a caricature artist when I was, I think I was 18 years old at a theme park called Frontier City. I wasn't, I did a lot more of like temporary tattoos than I did the caricatures because I wasn't really good with the marker that you have to like do the caricatures with. So, but I was better with an airbrush. Even though at the time I really wouldn't consider myself an airbrush artist because I was just spraying through stencils. But yeah, I was better with the airbrush than I was the marker. So even though I don't consider that officially my first time to airbrush because I mean, I guess it counts, but I didn't know what I was doing. Well, I haven't done a portrait like this in so long. This is like super, super fun. Like I'm having a great time. I should do stuff like this more often. If I could like make money doing just this, just doing portraits of people like caricature style, oh my God, I would have such a freaking awesome time. Okay, let's see. I made his chin way too high. I wonder if I can erase that out. Well, I guess I'll have to deal with it later. I'm gonna use some white and see if I can kind of kill that. Cool thing about white is you can actually go over all of it and it'll kind of like even all your tones out. And then you go back over it again. You'll have to redo everything you've already done, but it's a good way for sketching to go back and forth, which I do often when I'm like, I do it when I'm really patient. So you just have to kind of blend it out. The key here as a caricature is not to do some of the subtle details, like get the face right, but make sure your proportions stay exaggerated. No, I haven't. Nope. I've taught classes that he's been to and or been at, present at. Actually, you know what? Did I ever teach with Drew Blair where he was working there? I think I've
No, you've just been to the getaway. You've never taught at the getaways, right?
No. So actually, I didn't teach with him. I I've been to the getaways while he was there, but I've never taught or, like, really been around his class too much. I nearly took an apprenticeship with him, but I decided against it. I can't remember why, to be completely honest. See, I think I should exaggerate that kind of jugular thing, the kind of gobbler he's got going on a lot. So I'm going to bring this down. I put it on too wet, that's what I'm doing right now. I have too much reducer in there because I was using this for illustrative purposes, like, but I should have, in order for this to cover faster, I should not have so much reducer in there. So maybe I'll just add more paint to it. Maybe I should do a caricature of one of those Lion King people.
Joe Exotic?
Joe Exotic. I couldn't find a cool picture to work from with him, but... So here's that technique right here. That's the like jiggle technique or whatever. Remember Jaime Rodriguez called it Tourette's hands. Hopefully that's showing up good for you guys. How do you think, Brian? Does it look good? It's a good angle? Hopefully. You can see about kind of better how it looks. Thank you. So Faith and I have been watching this show called Schitt's Creek, and this guy reminds me a lot of a character on that show. He's the owner of the body shop. I grew up in a body shop. I couldn't think of the word body shop. When we airbrush or we paint or tattoo, in the tattoo world, we have this thing we call tattoo brain. It's when we can't recall words. So everybody's always asking us things when we're done with a tattoo, like dates or words or whatever, and we can't think straight because I think our brain is so much into that art side of your brain that we can't access the, like, you know, the other side, whatever that is, left or right, I don't know. How long have we been married? We're not married, but we've been together for 7+ years, maybe, somewhere around there. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. All right. Oh, you're in California. All right then, Brian, take it easy. I'll probably just play with this anyway, but we'll see you later. I'm going to end it. Those of you watching, I'm going to pick this one back up on another stream. I'm having a good time with it. Those of you watching in the future anyway. But yeah, I'll let y'all know when we get back into it. See you later.